हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम मिसेस हर्षा धोपे फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भाईंदर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल, दैट इज प्रोग्राम टू इम्प्लीमेंट 3D ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। इन थ्योरी लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट 2D ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड 3D ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। वी रिक्वायर 3 डायमेंशनल ज्योमेट्रिक एंड कोऑर्डिनेट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन to change the view of a 3-dimensional object. 3-dimensional transformations are extended from 2-dimensional transformations by considering the z coordinate. We have studied in 2D transformation, we have to consider only x and y axis, and in 3D transformation, we have to consider x, y and z axis. Just like 2-dimensional transformation, in 3-dimensional transformation are formed by composing 3 basic transformations of translation, scaling and rotation. We have discussed these in detail about translation, transformation, scaling and rotation. First, we'll see what is translation. Translation transform simply moves every point by a certain amount horizontally and a certain amount vertically. If xy is the original point and x1, y1 is the transform point, then the formula for translation is just we have to add x in the original points. That is x1 equals to x plus e and y1 equals to y plus f, where e and f are translation factors. As discussed in theory, in 3D transformation we have to consider 3 axes x, y and z. Then we'll see the techniques or the coding to implement that. So first of all, we need to draw a 3D object. Then how can we draw the 3D object? Here we are going to use bar 3D function that is defined in your graphics.h library of C. Then the syntax of bar 3D function is given on the screen. That is void bar 3D inside the bracket left coordinate, comma top coordinate, comma right coordinate, bottom coordinate, depth and top plane. Bar 3D draws a 3-dimensional rectangular bar by taking these parameters. For translation of the rectangular box, first we draw it using bar 3D function and then we have to take the translation factor as input and then again use bar 3D function with the new coordinates, that is new left, top, right and bottom. The next, you have to study the coding part. C program for 3D translation is given below. First, we have to consider hash include stdio.h. Okay, you have to write here brackets, rectangular brackets. Then hash include graphics.h. Then hash include math.h. Next, we are taking void trans function. The next, inside this, these are the left, top, right, bottom parameters for bar 3D function. Earlier, we have discussed what is bar 3D function. Then we are declaring the variable as integer max x, max y, mid x and mid y. Then let's see your main function. You can see your void main function. Inside this we have to declare integer, ch variable, then gd and gm variable you have to declare, and using detect graph and init graph you have to initialize this. Then next you are calling trans function. Then you have to return 0 and then close bracket. Then what is your trans function? It is explained below. Then next see your trans function definition, that is void trans, and then inside this trans function you are declaring this variable, integer type variable, x, y, z, o, x1, x2, y1, y2. Then we are initializing the value of mid x and mid y, that is 200, mid x equals to 200, mid y equals to 200. Then next, that is your particular function to draw 3D rectangular box. Earlier we have studied bar 3D function is used to draw rectangular box in a 3D format. So That's your bar 3D function. Bar 3D in bracket mid x plus 50 comma mid y minus 100 comma mid x plus 100 mid y comma mid y minus 50 and then 20 comma 1. What these coordinates are that we have discussed earlier. Then to see your particular output, you are using a delay function. The next, you are taking the translation factor from the user, that by which amount you have to translate that particular 3D rectangular box. Then after translation again you are declaring the bar 3D function. This bar 3D function, again, it is used to show your output after translation. Then this is your void trans function. Then next, your output, first it will ask, first we are going to insert translation factor, that is 20 20, and then after translation you can see this is your before translation and this image is your after translation. Thank you for watching this video.